Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Hidde Politiek. I'm a student here at Wageningen University in economics and governance and focusing on agricultural economics. And in the beginning of this year, I've done a research on the impact of this new regulation or the ruling of the EU Court of Justice for the Dutch plant breeding sector. And that's what I would like to share with you, because it's basically the first empirical data that exists on this side. So just, we've been talking about it quite a lot, I would say, but just to recap a bit on the current legislative situation. So obviously you have this 2001 EU directive, which regulates the exposure of genetically modified organisms into the environment. And now we have this Annex 1B, which makes an exemption for classical mutagenesis. And so the question that basically raised was, where does CRISPR-Cas belong in this picture? Because it being a mutagenesis-based system, of course. So the final word was said about this in July 2018 with a ruling by the EU Court of Justice, which said there's just no exemption from this 2001 directive. And this is basically the starting point of my research. So basically the question that posed after there were a lot of rumors about what the impact would be, but there was no one who really had studied it so far. So the starting point of this research is, what does this mean for the Dutch plant breeding sector in terms of investments, competitiveness, and the future? So just shortly about the Dutch plant breeding sector, we have approximately 100 plant breeders in the Netherlands, actually a little bit less, with if we exclude all the ornamental breeders and also all the propagators. And then just to put it in context of the global trade in seed, 40% of the traded vegetable seeds and 60% of the seed potatoes are of Dutch origin, so it's quite a significant sector, I would say. And then the sample had 72 companies, which is quite a decent response rate. And basically what this research did is we post statements to the R&D managers of these companies, which could be answered on a 1 to 5 scale, in which 1 relates to strongly disagree and 5 to strongly agree. And first of all, it's good to recognize that these companies actually have financial barriers because of this ruling. But the more interesting results, I would say, are with the investments, for example. So we see that both small and large-sized companies experience negative results on their investments in CRISPR-Cas. And when we look at the competitiveness, we see basically the most surprising result is with the potato farmers in this case. Actually, these potato farmers have a quite high potential in improving their development times. But we see that they don't experience that much negative effects in terms of their competitiveness. Although I must say that basically the large two companies might have think different about it. Then the last thing I want to differentiate on in these results is that there's a difference between the companies who have an EU main market, because those companies, they're more concerned with having an equal playing field, and some say that they don't care too much actually because they're more concerned with what the public wants actually. Whereas the companies who have a non-EU main market compete on other markets, so they're more concerned in this case. And the final thing I want to discuss with you is to give a bit of a look in the future. So basically you see quite a strange thing here. On the one hand, when we pose the question, I believe there will be less stringent regulation out because in the next 5 years, we see that they're actually quite positive because only 80% disagrees with this. But on the other hand, we see that if we pose the question, I believe the Dutch plant breeding sector will lose its leading position in the plant breeding for food purposes, we see that they're actually quite negative. So the only way to sort of reconcile this idea is to have a sort of a time element, which is the final message I want to conclude with today, which is that there might actually, to mitigate these risks for this sector, there might be some time pressure incoming with the fitting regulation. That's where I want to conclude with. Thank you.